So hi Vartika, how's your day going on?
I'm having a pretty normal day, you know, the one you have in lockdowns.
Okay, and so NIFT result have been out now, so how are you feeling with such a good rank, and congratulations for such a good rank, dear.
Thank you so much, and I'm very thrilled, but I'm more shocked because I did not expect such a good rank, but yeah, I'm very happy about it.
Okay, so Vartika, talking about this NIFT 2020 exam paper, so how was the paper? Was it difficult? Was it easy or lengthy? How was it?
It was the art paper, the creative CAT paper was lengthy, but that depends upon how much you want to do, right? Because if you want to color everything and use all the techniques, it takes more time. But the general ability test, the GAT paper was, it should have been finished by the time. The time allotted was enough. And as far as hardness is considered, I believe that I found some parts hard, but in all the paper was okay. It was not easy, but it was not very hard too.
Yeah, because some students came up with this thing that the paper was very lengthy.
Yeah, the art paper in particular, because they did not specify, like usually in questions they specify that don't color it or color it, but this time it was not specified in all the questions, so our first approach was to color them all. So yeah, it became like it was an ordeal.
Okay, and coming up to the creativity section, Vartika, so like were you good at creativity from the start or you nurture it?
I was I was able to copy things. Like when I saw some artist's work, I was able to copy it to some extent. I would say that 50-60%, but I did not have my own ideas, and I was not aware of the techniques and how the colors that should be used together. That's where Pehel comes in. They taught me how to, you know, what I had in mind. I was not able to draw from memory or whatever I wanted to draw. I always needed a reference. That's what they taught me, how to do that.
Okay, great. And now, if I talk about the GAT section, Vartika, what subjects and section took more time to solve and, your time to devote in the GAT section?
The most time-consuming one would definitely be English. The comprehensions were really tough, I would say, because, you know, as an ICSE student, we are expected to be very good at English, you know. It is said that ICSE students are very good in English and all, but it was very tough because I had to read it all again and again, and I had to mark the words. And, I studied a lot because sir told me that English is of very high level, but I did not expect it to be, you know, like this, because it was really confusing too. But I guess that's where it... increased my marks, because I was able to attempt all the comprehension questions and most of them were right. But it took a lot of time doing the comprehension. Then I guess the aptitude section, particularly involving the maths one, it takes time because you have to do the calculations, but it was not very hard. Like if you have studied nicely in 10th, you know, if you know the tricks, a little bit competitive tricks, you would be able to do it easily.
Okay, so, and what about the GAT the GK section, Vartika, the GK which comes, what kind of questions comes, and if you can share some questions that was there in GK, and how did you manage to do the GK part?
Sir took a GK class every week and gave us a lot of notes, and he shared PDFs with us. I, you know, thoroughly went through them. I at least tried to remember all that sir gave us, because I'm not very good in, you know, general knowledge things, and I don't even read the newspaper and all. I'm not very good at that, but sir told me to do so, so I did. And the fashion related GK had some part in it, but mostly I guess static GK came more this time, about history of India and some, you know, usual things that were actually the current things that were going on. some questions were pretty easy, but and some were like, I haven't even heard of them. They were like, okay, what is this? I don't know.
Okay.
You can do it, but I guess you should pay more attention to the things you can know for sure, like English, maths, and those things. You can know for sure that you can do it. But in GK, you're never sure what will come.
Okay. And through that, coming to the new changes and the negative marking that was implemented this year. So, Vartika, how did you cope up and manage the negative marking?
I first did all the questions. I was damn sure that I will get them correct. And after that, I attempted the questions which I was doubtful about. And I, you know, sir told me that attempt the questions in a way so that even if you suffer because of it, even if you get negative marking, it is balanced by the marks you get from the questions you attempted or the guesswork. Guess in a way that it doesn't cost you anything or it favors you. So I did the questions in a way that even if I got the negative marking, it did not affect me to that extent because I was not going to attempt those questions anyway.
Right.
So I attempted them actually. Was able to get some of them right, so you know it just lost them, and I actually favored from it.
Okay, so student have to do and attempt those questions only which they know that 100% they are right. Right.
First of all, they should do all those questions which they are practically 100% sure about. So because you don't want to miss anything, right? At least you should be able to complete what you know. Mm-hmm. And I was able to see that many of the students were, you know, hung upon some questions in the exam hall. I was able to finish it like 2-3 minutes before.
Mm-hmm.
So many of them were hung upon one question and they were doing it again and again. That's something you shouldn't do.
Yeah,
because, right. You know, if you know it, move on. Because you don't have that much time with you.
That's right. And coming up to the school study, so how did you manage? I think you were in 12th, right? Yeah, so how did you manage your school along with the preparation for NIFT and entrance exam?
That was the hardest part for me because, you know, I was a science student. I was not sure until I, you know, joined PEHEL what I wanted to do. So I was a science student with maths, computers, physics and chemistry. And I went for tuitions for all the four of the subjects.
Mm-hmm.
So during the week, 5 days of the week, I went for the tuitions and 2 days to PEHEL. PEHEL was really helpful in that because if they had the week classes like all of the usual coachings do, I wouldn't have been able to cope up with it. Right? Because I cannot actually sacrifice all the board studies because I want to go to a science college. So the weekdays I studied for in the coaching. And yeah, one thing I did was that I made one sketch or drawing or something like that every day so that, you know, I always stood in touch with it.
So like
because sometimes... What?
The object study basically. Every day you used to do object study. Yeah, okay.
Yeah, something like that because I personally was not very good at shading.
Okay.
And coloring was not... I was very bad at that, so I focused on that. And one more thing that I made sure that I did was that whatever the homework was assigned by the coaching, I made sure that I did it because that's the least I could do. You know, they told us to do many things, but that's the one thing that I made sure that I did. And sir used to check it personally, you know, every student's file. They checked it personally and they, you know, pointed out the flaws and not only the flaws, but also where we are good at so that we can, you know, focus on that too. Because in exams, you cannot just do everything. So what you're good at, if you implement that, it will always help you. So yeah, I guess the teachers were pretty amazing. They always helped me because even when I was not able to attend the weekend classes, sometimes it happened because I was hyperactive student in school. Like I was always in all the activities. Like you name an activity and I was there, be it sports, academics or anything. So, and I did not know how to compromise in that matter. That's a bad thing for me, but okay, I like to do it. So, sir would always, you know, he would change the time slot sometimes. Sometimes he would personally come and teach me. And whenever I reached him, he always taught me that this is how it should be. So, I guess the teachers were the ones who helped me manage it all.
Okay, great. And talking about the school studies, Vartika, so as you know, the school studies are more on the subjective side and the entrance exam is more on the conceptual based. So like, how was the transition and how did Pehel help you in this reaching the level of success?
I guess that, you know, I personally believe that in whatever stream you are, it will benefit you in some way or the other. Like, art students had some leverage over me in the creative part, but then I had leverage over them in the aptitude part because I knew how things actually work because of my science background. And Pehel, you know, Pehel did not, you know, point out the flaw that I was not an art student, so I cannot do it. They did not do that. They told me that if you're a science student, take advantage of that. You know how things work, so you should write them or, you know, show them your art, that how they will work. So that actually helped me because there were some questions, in there are questions that design an umbrella or something, future umbrella, future devices. So I was able to list the materials and, you know, how it would, the mechanism, how it would work. So I guess that would have definitely leveraged me over others.
Okay, that's great. Really good to hear that. So, secondly, I just want to know what tips and suggestions you would like to give to the NIFT aspirants, Vartika, so that they can score well.
First, I believe that students take NIFT very lightly. They are like that if we study for 1 or 2 months, we can do it. But it's not like that. You have to study from the very beginning, because if you think that you can, you know, cover all of the art part in like a month, then you are wrong, because you cannot cover it in a lifetime. There's so much to it, color theories and all. So you should be practicing from the very beginning, and you should, you know, create a schedule that you have to do this much every day. Sometimes like 12 students, especially the students who appear for the boards, they find it hard to take out time. So I would say that, you know, I used to always reduce the sleep time. Like I used to study at night and wake up really early and then do the things and focus.
So you prepared a timetable?
Yeah, I prepared a timetable that, you know, and of course, don't forget to rest, because if you overwork yourself, you will not be able to remember anything. So yeah, there was a timetable, my tuitions and my coaching excluded. I made a personal timetable that I have to cover all these topics. And to be honest, if you have like, we all have like 8 months, at least 8 months to prepare. And in 8 months, you can absolutely cover everything. The syllabus that has been provided to us, you can absolutely cover everything. You can, you know, make your art better. And some students complain that they're not very good at drawing or sketching or coloring. And I personally was one of those students. Now I'm a little better at it.
Of course you are.
Yeah, of course I am now. But I think what matters the most is how creative you are and how you're able to present it. Like if, even if you are not very good at drawing and you're not able to, you know, convey exactly what you wanted to write there, what it is in on your mind, because that helps. Even the examiner will find it useful that if he can see that you want to convey this, okay, it conveys that. So it will help you. Only advice is that be focused. Don't think that it is a fashion institute, so you will be able to get in there easily. Ask all the rank holders how much they have to work hard for it. Be no official. And yeah, just be focused and work hard. You'll get it. Don't worry, you'll get it if you work hard.
Okay, great. And coming up to the end of the session, Vartika, so I think these are the really good tips and tricks which you have shared with the aspirants. So I would like to ask again that what tips, magical tips you want to share with the aspirants basically, so that they can crack NIFT next year with a rank?
First trick would be to join Pehel because they are the ones who, you know, they actually are the ones. I was not even going to fill the, you know, paper for NIFT, to be honest. I was not going to fill it. And sir actually told me that do it, you can actually pass and get a good rank. So I did it and well, here I am. So and, about the paper, I will suggest that do comprehensions, a lot of comprehensions. Try to, you know, increase your vocabulary knowledge, because it, the English that comes in the paper is not like the usual English we speak. Yeah, we can all speak English, we are good at it, but you have to be a little, you know, extra good in English. Right. Because I guess fashion design, where you have to communicate the most, you know, communicate through designs or whatever, all the things are there. And I'm going in fashion communication, so my main line is only communication. So they take into consideration your English very much. Even half of the paper, I will say that half of the GAT paper consisted of English, and it holds the maximum marks. In my opinion, it holds the maximum marks. Even if you're not very good at, you know, in simple vocabulary, you don't know many words, they don't ask you words out of the universe. Like, you know, they don't ask you Shashi Tharoor language.
Okay.
It's impossible to know Shashi Tharoor language.
Yeah.
But if you read books, I used to read a lot of books. I love reading books. Read simple books, like not very high level English, but simple books, because then you know the words that are used in day-to-day language, mm-hmm. right? When you're, because sometimes in CAT also, they ask you to write a paragraph. This time also, they ask you to fill a grid and convey what you want to convey with it. And there I just wrote every ounce of English that I had in me. So, I guess first things first, work every day. Second, improve your English. And third, you know, third is, even if you're not very good at art, even if you cannot draw everything, try to enhance your creative mind. You know, I did that through the teachers. They told us so many things and they asked us to, there were some, what do we call them? Workshops also on creative abilities and all the aspects of creative and six components of designs and all. And they asked us to watch some movies. Like literally, they asked us to watch some movies that would help us. And I watched so many movies. Who isn't a movie buff, right? Watch the movie that will help you go ahead in your career. Yeah, it really helped me. Yeah, like one is The Devil Wears Prada, and there's a very nice speech there, and by Meryl Streep. They should hear it. It's really nice, and it will help them. And you know, I followed a lot of artists online on my Instagram, and I saw how they worked.
What kind of artists, Vartika?
You know, there are pages, but of course my friends, the ones I met in coaching, they were like, you know, when I first came to coaching and I saw their artworks, I was like, how am I going to compete with them? I mean, you look at their artworks and they're like, damn it, they're so amazing. And then I started following them and I started working hard. They suggested me some pages like there are Nolina Bright and pages like Art Supporters and Daily Art, a lot of pages. I have a lot of artists who I follow. And, you know, don't follow the artists who are, don't just follow the artists who follow the general line of art. You know, like they saw something and they create real, very realistic portraits or something. Follow those who create very, you know, abnormal things. You know, like you don't usually see those things. The art that evokes in yourself the feeling like, oh my god, we can draw it like that. I never thought like that. You know, those kind of artworks, those art pages will help you look at things in a different manner and use things in a different way. So, expand your creative mind as much as you can And literally, that's the easiest thing you can do among all other things, because you can watch movies, you can read books, you can follow pages, you can actually draw. I guess every designer aspirant likes to draw. I think that's one of the main necessities of it, that you like to draw and you like to color.
Yes, of course.
And do that and seriously work on your English, because, and do the past papers. You will know what I'm talking about, because the English, you have to be very good at it. Like, if they say something, you have to know what they mean, each word, what they mean, their antonyms, their synonyms, and one new thing, I guess, color theory. You know, if you use colors, you know, each color conveys something, some emotion, some place, holds some place in some religion. If you know the color theory, I guess you'll be able to attempt the questions, at least half of the questions, brilliantly. Because, you know, if you know the colors, if you have a good grasp at colors, you will create something that will be appealing to the eye, that immediately will appeal to the eye. And that's what the, I guess, examiners look for. Because I guess there were 6 questions this time. I don't even remember how many questions this time. It seems like forever ago. They were like questions, and I can, and there were 4 to color. So my color questions were quite better than the ones with the shading, because, you know, color doesn't wear off, also it doesn't smudge. And are being distributed, the shading smudges and it just becomes untidy. I tried to make it really tidy and, you know, just appealing to the eye, because the first impression should be like extraordinary for a good rank. I guess that would be all. I guess I've spoken too much.
Great, Vartika. Really nice talking to you, Vartika. Thank you so much for this session. And I hope you very all the best for your career, dear. I hope you bloom in your career, dear.
Thank you so much.
Thank you so much, Vartika. Thank you.